Hello.
Hello.
Can't deliver your project until you tell me what to do. But seriously, please reply. I literally have work to do. Hey, I'm Carrie. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome for the very first time. All around, welcome. I'm Carrieblogger, a career freelancer on Fiverr.com, where I've been selling as a Fiverr Pro verified copywriter for about the past 9 years. And in today's Freelance Friday video, we're talking about client communication strategies. Specifically, how to make clients reply when they're dead set on ghosting you. But before we get into that, we have to announce this week's blogger of the week. And if you would like to be the blogger of the week, just like coding is fun, all you have to do is drop a comment down below and you might get picked. Okay. So, like most of my videos, I want to start with a little preface, a little warning, a little disclaimer, if you will. Let's just remember that we are all humans. We've all got things going on in our personal lives. We've got so many distractions to deal with. For all you know, they are not responding because they got in a car accident and they're in the hospital. Or maybe they're a frazzled parent and they have to decide between answering your email and cooking dinner for their kids. Or maybe they just actually are a douchebag who do not value your time at all. The truth is gonna fall somewhere on that scale. So I just encourage you to, you know, always give people the benefit of the doubt. Just be a genuine, trustworthy, compassionate human. You know, just be a good person. And I think that the messaging is gonna be so much more effective if you frame it as everything for their success rather than your wasted time. That's gonna be more successful with how you think about this experience and also how they perceive your outreach. First up, be proactive. Let's start with the easy no-brainers. Let's get that out of the way. If you promise to do something in 7 days, you wait till day 5 to actually read through things and realize that you need more information, you're in trouble. So I always recommend that you check the order requirements, make sure you have everything figured out, send those follow-up questions, ideally the same day that they place the order, if not before. Tip number 2 is to ask all of your questions at once. Just keep in mind that like if they are not super responsive or they've got a lot of things going on, you don't want to be stuck in a back and forth battle. Lay out all your questions, confirm all of the details, give them a really clear, actionable list that they can go back and just do. Because you really don't want them to ghost you again once you get one question answered and still have a bunch of follow-ups that are still unresolved. Of course, managing your workload and staying on top of all this communication is infinitely easier with the right business tools. For that, let's talk about today's video sponsor, Landmark Labs. Landmark Labs just launched Clarity OS, an all-in-one Notion workspace that gives you customizable tools to run your entire freelance business, including project proposals, digital product creation, invoicing, budgeting, a calendar, task manager, and more. Everything syncs up together in a clean, user-friendly dashboard. Choose from pre-built templates or build out a custom solution that matches your unique business. Prices start at just $47 with lifetime updates, and you can save 50% right now by using the code CARRIE50 at checkout. Just click the link in the description. And thanks again to Landmark Labs and Clarity OS for sponsoring this video. Back to the list. Number 3 is to ramp things up in a logical way. I like to think about my reaction to this issue on a scale. It like, you know, escalates. I'm not gonna start out at threat level midnight for no reason. And the language that I use in these outreach messages evolves over time. So first up, it's just like, hey, wanna check in, I have some follow-up questions. Then it's more like, hi, please confirm that you've received my message. Then it's really important that I hear back from you soon. And then finally, it's like, urgent. Please reply as soon as possible to avoid automatic cancellation of this order. So if you're starting every message with these just like nonsense, what's it called? Pleasantries. Hey, hope you're having a really good day. I just wanted to check in. Like by then the message preview has ended and they don't have any idea how important it is that they actually read in, click and respond. Number 4 is to also logically increase the pacing of these outreach messages. This should happen naturally. You don't want to annoy them, but you need to show that eventually this becomes kind of a problem. Start with just one message a day. You're just trying to ping their attention. You're just trying to keep them in the loop, show that you're being proactive, show that you're still on the ball and that you haven't forgotten about them, even if they have forgotten about you. But with my 7-day delivery period, after about 3 days of no responses, then I start amping it up to, you know, 1 in the morning and 1 at night. By day 5, I'm up to about 3 messages a day. And on day 6, that is a last ditch effort telling them absolute last chance. You have to get back to me now. Otherwise this will be canceled by customer service. Tip number 5 is to know their schedule. So it seems really logical to message them, you know, in the middle of the day for their particular time zone when you think that they're most likely to be at their desk and in the middle of work. But also think about how busy you are in the middle of your day. So I think it's also a good idea. You can disagree with me, but I think it's a good idea to also message on their off time. So knowing their time zone, send a message when they are, you know, asleep at night, because theoretically they're going to wake up to that message and at least maybe they have a better chance of starting their day or seeing that before they get overwhelmed with all the other things that we have to do over the course of a day. Tip number 6 is if you can message them in multiple places, you should. Again, this is like a peak escalation strategy, I'm telling you right now. Do not day one send them an email blast and an inbox blast and an order blast and stalk them on Instagram to send them a DM. No. But by day 3, when I'm upgrading to my morning and night double hitter strategy, I'm also going to copy and paste that message from the order form into the inbox or, you know, into an email or into a secondary messaging channel, however your system works for your clients. Not only because twice the notifications, I think, you know, leads to twice the chance of a reply, but also because sometimes people just are not as tech inclined as I am. And it's possible that they just have more trouble accessing that part of the site. If we've already talked in the inbox, I know they can find that. I know they know where that is. So at the very least, maybe it's a little bit easier for them. And last tip is number 7. Prepare them for a resolution. Make sure that they know what's going to come up next and how things are going to change or adapt once you finally get the answers you need. Because chances are you're not going to be meeting that original deadline that was originally promised. I don't think it's a good idea to spring this change on them at the last minute. It might seem like a no-brainer to you and I that 5.5 days that was wasted was not actual work time, but to them, they might not compute that. Instead, you know, back that up, maybe day 2, 3, you start prefacing that and saying, hey, once things get going, once I get the information we need, we may have to, and then we will have to change the delivery time to accommodate that. So the way I always phrase it, my motto is that the 7-day delivery period starts when I receive all of the information that I need to complete the work. Depending on the delay, we may need to extend that delivery timer to reset the 7-day period. And I always describe it as resetting. That's very intentional in my language there, because that's really what it is. It's saying what's currently on the order, what you're seeing is not correct. The 7-day delivery period is what is promised, and we need to reset the order to look and feel and function the way that was originally promised in your quote. So, good luck with your ghosts. They're so annoying. Not every single person do these strategies work for, and sometimes I really do have to just cancel and say, what the heck, man? But with these strategies, you can dramatically increase your rates of success and end up canceling less orders. Canceling fewer orders, I guess, is the correct way to say that. If you're still watching, you know you are my actual hero. Thank you so much. You can check out what I've got going on in the pinned comment and description down below. And I have the most exciting news ever, which is my dystopian sci-fi novel, I've been pitching forever, is officially available for pre-order at carriefrenchauthor.com. Go, go, go. Grab a signed copy. Grab some limited edition book merch while it's available. I am so excited to share the story with you. Okay, so the blurb is, in a futuristic utopia that guarantees mild contentment in the lifestyle of your choice, our protagonist is depressed and adrift. Are you hooked? You should be. CarrieFrenchAuthor.com. Check it out. Please, please, please support me and this book and you're gonna love it. Last but not least, you are worth so much more than your workload. And let's get back to work.